Motherfuckers, this is Inappropriality. I am DJ Mike George.
Mac Way.
Ron Buddha.
B Money.
Mike Neff, you already know. Infinite Republic. We here.
Shout out our sponsors, Haiku, Terry's Tees, All About Business. If you'd like to sponsor the show, just contact me and we could definitely, for the low, low, ain't even that much. Ask. Yeah, ask. Just ask. It's real simple. Hit that like and subscribe button one time.
I said, what happened to that?
We're gonna do the next sponsor. Yeah,
word, yeah, nah, hell yeah. But yeah. Monthly too, monthly, just a monthly fee, and then we'll keep you up here 4 weeks, and then we'll promote y'all throughout the week, our social media and all that shit too. Yeah, and then have some merch for the table, just like that. I mean, probably stay on there any goddamn way. Yeah. I mean, shit, be dope.
Absolutely.
How y'all motherfuckers been? Y'all got a crazy surgeons. This motherfucker, for real.
Motherfucker came out gang deep in this.
Yeah, man. You know, we had to come with the. We always gotta come with the gang, you know, the gang always on deck. But I mean, our slogan is shop with the bros, you feel me? So our shit is really about, I mean, being bros, I mean, being tight with each other, being organic.
Real shit. Well, y'all wanna come together to even start this company?
This shit started as an idea, man, like a circa, 2012, 13. We was out here pushing hats, and I mean, we were just pushing hats, but we never, I mean, pushed the idea any further. You know, family got in the way, family situations and shit like that. You know what I mean? But for the most part, I came to the bros like, yo, man, I've been shooting out some ideas, man. I think we should put these shits out there. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And we started with T-shirt and a dream, man. That's where it started. Where I put a T-shirt up online, like, this is how it really happened, man. Even y'all even commented on it, so I put a T-shirt up just to see how people would react. And then they was like, yo, man, let's fucking do it. So that's really how it came about, man. It's about just believing in yourself.
Everything is in-house? Y'all do everything and make the shirt yourselves and everything?
Everything is in-house, man. I mean, we got a couple people that we deal with, but for the most part, as far as designs and everything come, like...
Right, you creating all the logos, right?
Yeah. I do all the designs. I mean, but if it wasn't for this man right here, a lot of this wouldn't be possible, man. He's a machine, man. I'm telling you, this dude.
All right, why you say that? Why you say that? What's good?
Ultimate hustle.
Whatever you need, I got it for you. If you need it, his hair, I'll bring it to you, whatever you pull up.
Whatever. Yeah, man, you know how you done, like, hit somebody up? I mean, you like a local brand or something, you see something and you hit dude up, he give you the running around or something like that. Mm-hmm. Don't hit my man Ron Buddha up. Ron Buddha at your front door.
On time.
He did it on time with the bag in hand, all that, ready to serve you. I'm telling you, man.
It's gotta be quality service,
service
is definitely something a lot of people don't talk about. I don't think we really touch much on it. It's definitely important to have quality service.
Yeah. Yo, customer service is big, man. That's that's the number one reason a person won't fuck with you. You know what I mean? Like, you ever been to a restaurant and it's just like somebody with a bad attitude? You ain't even taste the food yet, and I mean, you don't even want to go there. You know what I mean? So that shit goes a long way, man. Just treating your customers right.
I think that's definitely one thing I will give you some definite praise for, you know what I mean? Definitely a shopping, I say, in these past couple of months with a lot of motherfuckers. Niggas don't understand, if you putting out a product, you gotta be by that phone. You know what I'm saying? Like, you hitting the motherfucker like, yo, I'm trying to shop with you, nigga. It's you 3 days later, like, bro, I just seen this.
Taking
shit, my
all day.
Yeah, like, nigga, you know black people got money that day. Don't hit me 2 days later, nigga. I'm broke, nigga. Don't fucking. I ain't got that same fucking money I was trying to spend 2 days ago, nigga. Don't fucking play with me. Don't play with me. You know damn well, nigga. Damn well.
Don't Wayne got an eighth.
Come on now. Yeah, I could have had something out of sync for a couple of fucking some time, nigga. Like, nigga. Gone, nigga. Nigga, you ain't answer.
Argue with a shorty that night.
Come on now.
Another bottle of Henny.
When I hit your ass up, it was an immediate response. What's good? Where you
that,
at? Man. Let's happen.
We try to do that. I mean, I'm not gonna act like I'm perfect. There's been times where I haven't seen people's messages, but what I tell people is like, there'd be some people that hit me up at like 10:30 at night. Me and bros just talking about that shit. Yo, I need a shirt for the club. Like, don't hit me up for the shirt for the club. 30 minutes before you go to the club. Like, you ain't going into Gucci at 10:30 at night.
Right.
You ain't going into Balenciaga or none of these stores at 10:30 at night. Those stores are closed. Normally around 9 o'clock, those stores closed. You feel me? So, like, treat this shit like a business as well. You know what I mean?
Word.
Just because you could call your mans up and get some shit doesn't mean you could call me up at 11 and I'm supposed to just stop what I'm doing and bring you a shirt or bring you a hat or bring you whatever you wanted. You feel me? I appreciate the love, but at the same time, it's like, I mean, you knew you was going out tonight. Nigga, hit me up at 6:30. Word. Nigga.
My office hours are from.
Yes.
Right, nigga. Office hours are from 9 to 5, nigga. But for us, nigga, we spread it out a little longer.
What have been some of the struggles of now jumping into merchandise and clothing and fashion? What have been some of the struggles that you ran into?
Oh, man, one of the biggest struggles is a lot of people won't admit it, is like the amount of money that you lose. You know what I mean? Trying shit out and like, damn, this don't work. You know what I mean? Buddha, you know what we done been through, man. We done got shit and, man, we got so much shit that we done printed out and was like, nah, this shit ain't gonna work. Nah, this ain't it. But we real careful about what we put out, you know what I mean? And another thing about that shit is you gotta be real careful on what you put out. You know what I mean? I done seen a lot of people make mistakes and put certain shit out, and then you got to explain why you put that shit out, and then there's people who's offended by it. You know what I mean? It's a lot of money lost before you make money, I'll tell you that. You know what I mean? And I'm learning now, when you're in the clothes business, it's like, don't look for a profit your first year around. Keep going back in until you're real comfortable with your product and what you like to put out, and you kind of got like a little trademark to what you put out.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, so when you look at most of our shit, you're like, I get they sequence of shit now. You feel me? We more like the less is more kind of guys. You feel me? And respect to all brands out, but we ain't localizing ourselves. You feel me? So like, we ain't mad people hitting me up like, yo, what's up with the 413 shirt and this and that. And it's like, nigga, we know where we from, nigga. Y'all know where this shit came from. You feel me? But a nigga in Philly can't wear that shirt. You know what I mean? A nigga in Chicago can't wear that shirt.
For sure.
A nigga in fucking Paris can't wear that shirt.
For sure.
And you know what I mean? We just thinking a little bigger, you know what I mean? And like I said, there's a lot of shit I done seen out here that's mad dope that represents the city, you feel me? But we just stay in our own lane. That's where we want to stay. We more of like we want to be a boutique.
That's definitely what I get from the brand. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, first look at it, I was like, obviously knowing the music that's behind the brand, you know what I mean?
Right.
And the target I feel for the music is like the clothing brand is kind of like universal. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, you see motherfucking white people in this shit. Like, it's some no dope bullshit. Shit. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, you know what I mean? So was that something that you put to your head? Like, I don't want to just target who I target with my music. I want to go low.
Yo, my bros is... My bros, fucking Buddha and Ali, man. Like, I mean, there's a bunch of us, you feel me? But as far as people with their hands most into it, as far as, like, the street hustlers, it's me, B, you know what I mean? Buddha, Fats, you know what I mean? And motherfuckers be on my back. I can tell you right now, I done sent these niggas designs I thought gonna kill them, and they'd be like, nah, that shit whack, bro. You know what I mean?
That's
but
dope that you have those type
win.
Of people. Yeah, right, that's dope. That's
good
dope.
That my niggas ain't yes men, you feel what I'm saying? These
need
are my
that.
Brothers, so they're gonna tell me, like, nah, that shit don't hit, or nah, that shit hit, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
And then we go from there, but they don't put, once I send them out they shit, I just sit back and them niggas just perform, you know what I mean? So it's kind of like we all play our own role and shit. It's not like, you know what I mean, fucking... You know, most dudes want to be Jordan and nobody want to be Pippen. You know what I mean? Forgetting
yep.
that Pippen took the Bulls almost to a championship by himself. You know what I mean? Without Mike.
You got
to
play your positions.
So this shit's all about positions. And once
yes, sir.
Some people realize that shit, they should have moved a little smoother. You know what I mean? And that goes with mad shit in life. You know what I mean? Not just clothes. It goes with music labels. It goes with fucking friendships. It goes with everything. You know what I mean? Everybody play their role. You know what I mean? There's people who do this, it's people who do that. You don't see the producer trying to spit bars.
Right.
Sometimes the producer can spit bars, but most of the time the producer trying to make the beat.
He wears his hat.
I mean?
He wears his hat. If you guys want to speak on to what your roles are in
the
brand.
Yeah, man, y'all speak up.
Yeah, I'm just just here for the people. If you need it, I'm here for you. Probably not more than that, like.
This nigga.
I'm just a runaround guy. If you need me, I'm here for you.
Tell your ass.
You hit his
my shit.
He's the he's the hidden gem and shit. You feel me? B is the nigga that's gonna come out the cut on you like, yo, nigga, you gonna spend some money or not, niggas? What you here for, nigga? You here for 2 hours, nigga? You knew your size before.
Whoa, nigga, where you come from?
Nah, nah, nah. He's nigga like, nigga, you knew your size before you got here. Stop trying to act like you don't know your size now, nigga. You know, nigga, hear the price and be like,
Now, well, I was just about to bring that up too. I literally had this shit highlighted because there's this stigma about customers complaining about local business prices and why they're not bro, so listen, low.
That's crazy.
Yo, like, listen, yo, listen.
Why do you think that is?
I'm gonna humbly say this, Nick. Before we even get into that, the answer to that question, my price is my price. Listen, you don't go in the fucking Big Y and ask for a fucking discount on your steak.
Point blank.
You don't go in the Subway and ask for a discount on your sandwich. You don't go in the Gucci and ask for a discount on your sunglasses. Like, nigga, my price is my price. I done seen motherfuckers out here rocking fucking $300 designer shirts and shit. Like, you can't spend 40 cents with me, then, all right, cool. Somebody else will. Simple as that. I'm confident in my shit to know that, all right, if you don't buy it, somebody else will. I'm not the dude that's going to down my shit. Because you don't want to spend the money I want you to spend. That's just it. 40, it is what it is.
40 not a bad simple price anyway.
40 is not a bad. Yo, I done spent.
You go to Against All Odds and buy random t-shirts.
I'm not even
like
putting
their
names out there. I done spent $60 on t-shirts out here on niggas. But because of the work I seen that they put into it. Mm-hmm. And now that I know, doing the shit myself, like, yo, this shit costs money. You know what I mean? And you got to make a profit somewhere. So, nigga, let niggas win, man. If you got some dope shit, people going to support it. Simple as that. People support dope shit.
Word.
Simple as that. You know what I mean? And I need one of them shirts. I'm asking for one.
Word, I got you.
Word.
Where do you think that mindset comes from with these people though? Is it just because they feel like it's you're so accessible people, and they know you?
Just trying to be cheap. Because if it was really, really cheap, what value would it have? Would you really want it?
Facts.
Word.
What you
know what I mean?
So. Facts.
Why you think niggas is like that, bro? Because I know you done dealt. Yo, you done dealt with that shit more than all of us, my nigga. You know that shit. Niggas done came to Buddha. Buddha hit me up like, yeah, this nigga done came to me with this bullshit.
Yeah, it's just like, it's levels to it. Because, like first, it's $40 to start for a t-shirt, right? People would do that just to support you, say they bought it from you. But then when they want their second and third and fourth shirt, like, then this shit might be a little expensive. So I might go to Nike and get my $15 shirt, $25 shirt instead. But it's just like, support goes a long way. If it's not support, it's just like, that's just what the people want.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's what we're really trying to separate our shit from is we done got the support now. The support shit is out the way. Everybody's going to support and unsupport it. Now it's keeping the loyal customers.
Now it's the support
is done with. Like, I showed you some love.
I saw a cat put up
but
a
now
status.
You got to keep up with me, like my style.
Word.
Is it dope or what? If not, I'll go back to what I've been doing. Give me a little polo tee, just go about my business. But if you got something to stand with it, we're going to go from there.
Word.
But I can't remember his name, but he put up a status and shit. And he was like, I remember back in the days when nigga, when I ain't have shit to rock, and now me and all my niggas wearing Fennet, you know what I mean? And I seen that shit, and I was like, damn, nigga really talk about this nigga, you know what I mean?
Kid Yannick.
Yeah. Shout out to Yannick, man. That shit was dope, man. Word. For him to say that shit,
that's
it was like, and he's like, him and his niggas look at our shit like it's Gucci, you know what I mean? Like,
that's
it's
real as fuck.
You know what I mean?
That's dope.
And that's dope, you know what I mean? And, yo, shout out to the supporters, man. This shit. Like I said, this shit started with a t-shirt and a dream, bro. I'm telling you, man, if you don't know the hardships that we done been through since we started this shit, you know what I mean? The times, nigga, where fucking some, like I said, we organic as fuck. We admit everything. There have been times where days went by and we done, damn, yo, what we gonna put out, yo? Damn, this shit is getting old. And then,
yeah, that's probably one of the biggest struggles is dropping the next thing.
Dropping the next thing, because it's like,
on top of the,
Not only that, I say that to say this. Springfield is y'all know Niff. I speak my mind. Springfield is the city of fucking followers. People are gonna follow every fucking thing they see. When they see something working good for somebody else, just because something working good for somebody else doesn't mean it's going to work good for you. But you know how the city works. So they see somebody do something, they want to do it too. But my biggest issue is you can't share your ideas out here.
Yo, what?
You can't even speak to a nigga about your idea and your next move. You tell a nigga your next move in Springfield, and your nigga is doing that shit next week. Tell me I'm lying.
Tomorrow.
Popping right now.
A nigga doing that shit tomorrow. Yo, Mac, I tell a nigga right now what I'm about to go do.
Tomorrow.
Tonight. Tomorrow, that shit gonna be on the internet for sale, nigga.
It's been like that since we was kids, though.
Yeah,
I remember being a broke kid and you telling nigga like, yo, I want these shoes, and the little nigga with the money, he go get them shoes.
He go get them shoes, right. Shit,
nigga. And rock them right in front of you.
You don't even know how to dress.
Them, nigga.
He got them shits on with a corduroy sweater. He don't even know how to wear them shits.
You want some bullshit with him. But that's the nigga. He just tried to style on you, though.
That's Springfield, man.
Hate. Yeah, but I don't see, yo.
Yeah, it's everywhere.
It's everywhere.
A nigga copy you, but you can just do it again. You can't lie. It just don't matter. Organic.
That's them niggas who go take the outfit off the mannequin. Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, bro can't dress.
Those are the you said it perfectly. Those are the outfit off the mannequin ass niggas, bro.
You ain't got no.
You feel nothing. Me? But
PCX.
At the same time, at the same time, what I'm saying is, I say I have to say this. People support dope shit. So regardless of whatever the fuck you do, or whatever you stole from the next nigga or something, if you either got the fucking juice or you fucking don't. Simple as that.
And people pay the fucking attention
that
too.
There's one thing you can't motherfucking buy, and that's the fucking juice. You can't buy the juice. You can't buy the sauce. Mm-hmm. You either fucking got it or you fucking don't. Simple as that. Words of my motherfucking pops. Words of Mike Niff, nigga. Words of Infinite fucking Republic Clothing Company, nigga. You either got the sauce or you fucking don't.
You'd be surprised how many people come up to you and be like, yo, I seen this person do this after you was doing blah, 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 blah. I was like,
Torch.
I seen it too, but so what? Like,
Torch, I can't do what you do, Torch.
That's all it was. I inspired my son.
I can't do what Torch does. Picture me trying to do what you do. They gotta be like, get the fuck out of here, man. Stay in your lane, nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Everybody
but there's some people out here that just, they just like that. You know what I mean? They fucking carbon copied and shit.
Yeah.
And there's some shit that just ain't carbon copied. If y'all niggas is organic. That's why I couldn't wait to come on y'all show, bro. I'm like, yo, these niggas is mad organic, man. I done seen so many episodes, and I'm like, yo, this shit is entertaining. And you can tell these niggas are really friends, and this shit ain't forced. You know what I mean? These are my brothers. These are my everyday niggas. You feel me? This is what we do on a daily. You know what
facts.
I mean?
It's definitely important to have those people around you. Because, like I said, like, it's not forced. It's not forced. Me and this nigga be arguing, or me and Carly be going back and forth. That shit is really what we be feeling like.
Bro,
we're not.
Niggas really speak how they
speak
their
mind.
Yeah.
Niggas don't care. Like
Vanessa, female, and still
speak
their mind. Like we say what got to be said. Like you can't grow without that harsh truth. You know what I mean?
Only strong as your circle.
My nigga. Da 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 da. I don't care how you take it. You can't talk to me for 2 weeks.
Shout out to my nigga Carla, man.
Yeah,
hell
Carla.
Yeah, shout out Kay. She
I know she couldn't be
locked
here tonight.
She out of lockdown right now.
Shout out to Ali Fats. He couldn't be here.
Yeah, yeah.
Shout out to the guy Fats.
The GOAT. Yo, we can make calls in here?
Yeah, go ahead.
You can do whatever you want.
Yeah, my man Ali said to call him up, man. Let me see if I can get him.
Special guest real quick.
Right. Would I call him on FaceTime?
Yeah, go ahead. FaceTime.
FaceTime.
Just FaceTime. And then just hold it up to the mic so that way camera can pick it up.
Alright, hold up. Let me call this.
Well, while you do that, one time I got shout out everybody that came through the split field because I mean it was definitely a dope event. Niggas was sweating in that bitch. It was hot as fuck up that bitch. Oh my god. But
five
shout out all the vendors.
That bitch.
Shout out all the vendors. Shout out everybody that came out. Shout out all the performers. Comedian Tom Roche definitely had me crying. I was in the corner dying. But it's always a tough crowd with them things because it's not a comedy show. So like I mean, I get up to the guy. It's dope as fuck.
Shout out to the guy, Ali Fats, man. Let's get this guy on the horn, man. My man's he under the weather, but yeah, man, we live, man. We under the set my guy
gotta,
under the weather.
Look a little
we
better
gotta get
than
him up on the phone, though.
God damn. Yeah, hold on. Yeah, get
around. Yeah, right. Where you already rocking the gear? Already know what time it is. What up, my dude?
What's good, gang?
Chilling, man. We need more music. We waiting on it.
No bullshit.
Hell yeah, man. We in here, man. You already know. We in here smoking.
We'll talk about the percentages later.
No bullshit. What's up? Where'd you go? We needed you on so we get to talk about them fucking shoes you done dropped.
Word.
Fucking the city up right now.
Yeah, man. Yo, yo, yo.
Time to turn shit up too.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right, go ahead.
You get me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. We can hear you well now. Yo, bro, I was trying to tell him, man. People want to know how to pronounce it. I told him it's Alex for Shaw.
Yeah, Alex Fashaw, man. Alex Fashaw, that's the name, man. That's gonna be the brand. That's gonna be popping out up under
the
clothing company.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Yeah, man, we got a lot of shit in the works, man.
I
know what's going on, man.
No, bro. This
the creatives,
man.
This nigga, the only nigga I know with a shoe. He got a shoe. And they're fire.
It is fire.
And they're fire. Right here, my nigga. What's good? Always. Now I'm saying your kicks are dope. Yeah, I mean, we already had this conversation. But nah, we got to tell the public though. Your sneakers is fire. You got to drop the links though. Word, niggas gotta grab some of them. I already know they about to be dope as fuck.
Yeah, this man, nigga. You already know. Yo.
The boots, nigga.
For the record, too, man. Yo, man, we about to have something go down really, really big, man, with the Alex for Shaws, man. So just stay tuned, man.
The Alex for Shaws.
That shit sound crazy. Word. I ain't even going front. I had no idea how to pronounce that shit. No,
yo.
I had no idea.
Everybody like Alex Fatui. Niggas is like Fatui for Ty.
Word.
Yo. You said what? Oh, yeah, man. Carla.
She had to be absent today.
Yeah, she had to be absent.
Yeah, she on lockdown. She on lockdown, unfortunately, right now. Yeah. So she couldn't come tonight.
She got locked down.
I didn't want to shout out everybody else and
they
get a chance to shout her up. I ain't
want to
be rude.
Shout out
Twin.
Shout out
to
Carla,
too,
man.
Yeah,
Twin, hell yeah.
Big dog.
No bullshit.
Yo, man, you know we here holding it down for the gang, man. Shop with the fucking bros, man.
Nah, I'm pissed I couldn't make it in the flesh, man. But it's all good, though, man. You know what I mean? We here. And we stronger than ever, man. And I already know. I know what's going on.
We're in due time, my nigga.
In due time, you know that, bro.
Okay. Yeah, man. Definitely, man.
Yo, before you get up out of here, man, just shout out the page and all that. Yeah. Shout out to Alex for Shaw joint, though. I'll take care of the rest of that.
Shout out to Alex for Shaw, man. Shout out to Finnegan Public Clothing Company, man. Shout out to, follow us on all the IG, John. You know what I'm saying? Follow on the IG. Follow Grand Buddha. Follow Mike Niff. Follow Ali Fats. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man. That's just, y'all know the brand. Y'all know how we keeping it. Y'all know how we carrying it, man. It's just, you know. Shout out to my Brody B in the building, too, man. Pardon me, man. Pardon
self,
man.
Shout out to
Brody B, man. Big dog. We'll talk about the sentences later.
Hey,
yo, we OB 6%. We OB about 12% by now.
Hold up. Now we got to up because y'all breaking the non-disclosure.
What you talking about?
Fire.
That's a fact.
Family shit, you know what I'm saying?
Work.
Gotta have them dogs, man.
Nah, man,
That's like 20 years plus. Mm. All right.
Follow the creatives, man. Y'all know what it is, man.
Ron
Buddha, man. Shout out to Mike Niff
and
his genius, man.
Yeah, y'all know, bro.
It don't get no better, man. You know what I'm saying? And we here, man. I'm about to lock in. I'm watching y'all, man. Shout out to Mike Torch, my motherfucking guy, man.
Word.
Shout out to Black Way, love. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Carla in her absence. You know what it is, man.
Yeah. Word. Tune in, nigga.
All right.
What's good with this? Yeah. This Monday Madness shit? What's that about?
Yo, man. Yo, so listen, man. I'm gonna just put it out there, man. Me and my man Brian Jones, you know, LSD culture. You know what I mean? Designer drugs, if y'all don't know. You know what I mean? We looking up.
Right. By his name.
Right.
Call the man by his name.
Whole name.
Know about that.
Yeah, it's nah. Still, but everybody know him by everything. Brian, know Brian know.
You
gonna
keep that nigga around there?
Yeah, this nigga ain't got.
His mama call him Brian. I would call him Brian.
Bro, that's been my man for 25 years, nigga. He met me as Michael Gibbs. I met him as Brian Jones. Shout out my nigga Designer Drugs, nigga. But me, my nigga Designer about to link up and we about to do 10 straight Mondays, man. Visuals. You feel me? I'm bringing bars back. I'm bringing back the hardest beats, nigga. You know what I mean? And I'm dropping 10 straight visuals every Monday. You feel me? Monday Madness with Mike Neff.
So we ain't even got to ask when we going to hear some new music.
Nah, man. You ain't got to ask, man. That shit coming soon, man. I think I'm going to start sometime like second, third week, September. Yeah. And run that shit all
the way
to Christmas.
That sounds like a great-ass time.
I'm thinking I'm going to run it all the way to Christmas. So however weeks that is, all the way to Christmas, that's when I'm going to do it. You feel me? I'm going to drop one on Christmas Day.
This was
Drake
Champs, just say that.
Yeah, right. Word. I feel like you Nori right now and shit. Word. I ain't getting a torch, nigga.
My bad.
Look at the heavy head and shit.
Nigga said, say win, nigga. Win,
nigga. Nah, Mac, man, shout
out. Like, I'm going to get the whole truth out of that.
I've been paying attention, bro.
Nah, definitely appreciate the opportunity to come on your platform.
Word. Thank you.
You're a good performer, though, man.
First public appearance.
Yo.
He made a post. He did my first podcast tonight. Yo, I was like, where? What's good?
Yo, bro, I ain't want to, nigga, I ain't putting bro on the hot seat or nothing, but you know, like, fucking Rockefeller, you had Jay-Z, you had Dame Dash, you had Biggs. He's Biggs. You know what I mean? He's the nigga.
He got much to say.
That's a dope comparison. That's the first time I heard some shit like that.
He's like this, nigga. He just like, he the business nigga. He hustling.
Biggs is that nigga, too.
Yeah, Biggs is that nigga,
he got
bro.
No problems with nobody. Like, this nigga, like.
Yeah. He just has.
He's just that nigga. And
I ain't
like,
got much to say,
knowledge-wise.
Nigga, I'm going to get it done, you feel me? I'm going to let, as you can see, Niff was the social dude, you feel me? Niff and Fast is the social dudes. For the most part, you know what I mean?
Damn.
Shout out to my brother Ant G too, man. He wanted to
take it on good word.
The owners of this company, my brother Ant.
Guess
my
I'm beans.
I'm not even
word.
Guess I'm beans then, huh?
You gotta shout out Ant G, you already know that.
Yeah, for sure. The big dogs.
Shout out to big dogs. They like the businessman behind this whole shit, you feel me?
All right, let's get into some madness, y'all. Are y'all petty exes? Y'all seen this nigga Ben Affleck sent fucking A-Rod some pizzas like randomly?
Yo,
pizzas.
Son.
He said, yeah, just pizzas. Just, like, it's just some annoying shit though, ain't it? Like,
it's annoying. Would you have ate the pizza?
It's annoying if a nigga sends some free pizza.
Yo, let me ask you a question.
Like, your ex's man.
Let me ask you a question.
Him should have eaten that pizza.
Let me ask you a question.
What if it's his favorite restaurant?
What's good?
My nigga,
his cheese.
If it was Red Room,
his favorite pie, nigga.
If it's all cheese, I don't eat pork, so.
Yo, if he's sending free pies, then I'm just saying, nigga, it's a
fuck
party.
Fuck, I'm about
nigga.
To be mad for. I'm calling the gang, nigga. Yo.
Yo.
Goofy nigga. Yo. Goofy nigga mad I'm fucking his bitch. Yeah. Nigga. He just sent pieces,
this
nigga,
goofy,
coming through. Which is a street.
This goofy nigga mad.
No. The boyfriend sent the ex pizzas.
Okay, that's petty. All right, that's petty. That's petty.
He's
petty.
A goofy ass nigga. I
thought it was the other way around.
The now boyfriend, the now boyfriend sent the ex boyfriend pizza.
He ain't got nothing else to do.
A-Rod sent the pizzas?
No. Ben Affleck sent the pieces.
Ben Affleck ain't with
J-Lo, no? Nah. Yeah, they're together.
That's the most
hoish.
Nah, A-Rod
with
J-Lo. That's the hoish.
They broke up.
The whole scenario just changed now. That's the most hoish shit I ever heard in my life.
Whoa, time out.
Ben Affleck and J-Lo are together right now.
They're back together?
Yeah, they're back together.
For real?
That's the hoish shit I ever heard in my life, bro.
Now, hold on. What's going on? Hold on.
You know that's J-Lo.
I missed this?
You know that's J-Lo.
Hold up.
This is like within the last couple months.
My nigga Batman got his bitch back. He this said, is my nah, pussy. Nigga.
Gotham, I'm here to save you.
It's my pussy, nigga. This is crazy. So he sent my nigga. So he sent my nigga A-Rod pizza.
I don't get it. Like, are you trying to start?
So he sent my nigga.
He let him know he won't. Let him know he took over the pie.
Yeah, that's this nigga stupid.
He said I took over the pie.
The new owner.
I'm getting all the box, nigga.
No, this the close. He said, "This the closest you get to a box."
The whole Yankees eating. We got a pizza party. The whole Yankees got a pizza party on fucking Ben Affleck.
He ain't a Yankee no more. He retired, nigga.
Oh, he out of the game.
Yeah, that's why. That's why he got time to send.
You know, the whole Yankees going to eat this now.
What does he do now?
I think he's part owner of a few teams. I think Marlins. I know. I'm pretty sure the Marlins.
And that requires him not to do nothing. So he got time to be petty. He got money and time to be petty.
That's some weird shit.
I ain't know that though.
It's weird. It's where
Mark Cuban breaking niggas off?
I don't know how to make it on his mind. So I guess
he can buy shares in all teams.
Damn, why would you send your ex, your shorty's ex, some pizza?
Maybe they exchanged words and he was trying to be funny.
Okay, it doesn't matter. It's that's mad, why,
that's mad weird, though. I'm
never doing no shit like that.
Yo, here, my nigga.
What?
I ain't sending this nigga a Cash App. Like, nigga, I'm not sending this nigga nothing.
I don't even know who this nigga is. Like, I ain't
worried about it. You kept her warm while I walked away. You kept her warm while I walked away. I'm back now. Here's some pizza.
The nigga Ben Affleck had J-Lo back in the day.
Yeah.
That's the kicker of it.
You know, his Ray J shit, I had it first.
That's his old bitch. Like, I hit it first.
Yep.
Then A-Rod had it. No. Matter of fact, Ben had it. Then Mark Anthony had it for mad years. Right?
This nigga pulling.
Was it Ben? Then Mark? Nah. Nah, hell no.
Yeah,
nah.
And then a couple today, dancers, right? Nah, and then like.
Mark Anthony. Hold up.
Yeah, because she was.
Who's first? Bro. Ben was before Mark Anthony.
I don't even know.
I don't know. It was
she got to be listen.
All I know is she had Ben before A-Rod, nigga. And
I just seen this story and I was like, A-Rod what?
It's gone and Ben is back.
I was like, that's what? Crazy.
She's fucking Batman again.
But come on, Ben.
Yo,
that's OD.
Bro, J-Lo's crazy, bro.
Yeah, oh yeah, so you know how much I didn't want to talk about that on this podcast.
He could have kept that
for himself. Yeah, that shit ruins my whole childhood.
Nah, Robin is bi.
In the new,
Robin is bi.
In the new comic.
I don't know, but his colors used to always throw me off. So it makes sense.
I was a fan of Nightwing.
Batman wore black. Batman wore black. He wanted a little red rhinestones. It was already there. So
he's a gymnast. All the signs was there.
No. He said he was a gymnast.
All the signs was there.
He didn't even have pockets.
The signs was there.
Yo,
the signs was there.
The signs was there. You seen his little goggles and.
No.
Hey,
this nigga have posters around.
Nah, we're definitely not doing
that.
Robin's my
nigga. Yeah.
Robin's
my
nigga.
Come on, Torch, let's move forward.
Yeah, next question.
Let's move forward, Torch.
You can't lose no ratings.
PJ Washington?
Who?
PJ Washington?
What happened?
Brittany Renner, you ain't see that situation?
Nah, what happened?
This is like, I guess she's a known slut. Had a tell-all book out and all types of shit like that.
Oh, nah.
She fucking...
I knew that.
She, I guess, got with this baller and got pregnant, married, had the baby, and then two months later,
divorced this nigga.
Divorced him. And
nigga paying
is getting
$200K a month.
Yeah. Shut the fuck up.
That's a good hustle.
Shut the fuck
up. Supposedly, like, in the past, she said that. To get a basketball player because they don't wear condoms.
He probably seen that. And was like, man, I'm gonna still take my chance.
200K?
Nigga,
ain't no damn baby worth no motherfucking 200,000 no goddamn month. Nigga. Ain't no baby.
200K? 200K? We gotta take a trip to the lake.
We gotta take
a little trip to the lake.
Oh, I ain't made 200K a year in my life.
I'm just hearing about this shit.
I ain't made 200K.
That'd be the next thing they hear about.
Fuck a month. I haven't made 20K a year. That'd be the next fifth of a million.
That's crazy. The next thing they hear about is that trip to the lake.
Nah, nigga.
It ain't gonna be no more 200K. Me and this little nigga out of here. It ain't no more 200K.
Nah.
This nigga said.
We both gone.
OJ did it. This nigga's stupid.
Nah, but. He's the dumbass.
Whole time I'm driving, it's your mama's fault.
Because she was viral with the shit before he hit it.
Yeah.
So he still hit it knowing what she's like. You set yourself up.
Maybe he ain't know that bitch though.
It's no judge.
Man, she was mad.
What judge ruled for 200,000 though?
Mm-hmm. It had to have been
a judge that's getting 50 of it. That don't even make sense to me.
Yeah, she's the judge.
No bullshit. Judge.
That bitch lawyer spoke to the judge. Like no. 50 for you every month, nigga. We take 150.
200,000.
We take 150.
What? I'll add 50 more.
Yo.
That's crazy.
We gonna run the rate on
that's
this.
That's all I wanna speak on, man, about what's going on right now, though, in the country, though, man.
What's talking about?
What's going on? Taliban shit.
Yo,
that's breaking news,
I didn't want to talk about
that. That has to be spoken about, bro.
I didn't want to talk about that. I didn't want to talk about that because that shit affects me crazy. Like, that's all I've been, thinking about this last.
I know you got a military background, bro. And, yo, bro, my father was a first sergeant in the Army. I was born in Germany, you feel me? I was born overseas, you know what I mean? I was a military brat, you know what I mean? So when I see shit like that, see Taliban niggas running down on fucking U.S. fucking jets and shit. Y'all see that shit?
I know
that
Marines.
Crazy, bro.
I yo, personally bro, work with Marines.
100% took over Afghanistan.
Nah, you see the niggas on a plane trying to hold on to the wheels?
Yeah,
they just dropping in the sky? That shit was crazy.
It's just sad. It's like...
Bro, that shit got me kind of nervous, bro.
You should be.
That shit don't got
because they're in control right now, so now they got it's a safe haven for them to there's like 30,000 left, and there's from what I understand
thousands of Americans.
There's only one road to get to the airport, and there's a checkpoint, a Taliban checkpoint on that right now. And they don't know how to get everybody back. That's what I understand right now, and then it's like what the fuck, how the fuck, and then
you
I'm thinking about
how many is still
30,000.
That's sick. That's sick, bro. And how many fit each plane?
I don't know.
Not that
like nah, hell no. Hundreds. Probably like 200, 300.
Yeah, you know what I mean? That's bro, that shit is scary, bro. That shit is scary. That's people family over there, you know what I mean? And that shit I think about. Some people don't think about shit like that, but I think about it. My dad fought the whole first Gulf War, you feel me? Desert Storm. And I remember going back and seeing people. Cause back in the days, technology wasn't the way it was, so you went and you waited, and if your family didn't show up, then you just...
It's just crazy how fast these motherfuckers did this shit. It was like 5 days. It was like five days.
Like,
it was like...
Yo, bro, I was watching the news like 5 days ago. It was like 65-70%.
Yo, it's
and
crazy.
Then I just seen like, yo, they entirely took over Afghanistan, bro. Like the whole entire country, bro. They have
I've personally worked with Marines that have been there and passed away. I personally work with Marines that have been there and came back without limbs. I personally know Marines that went there, came back, and committed suicide. Like, this shit is crazy. Like, that's all I'm thinking about, just watching this shit. Like, what the fuck was it for? Like, I work with these people, and they're fucking gone or got prosthetics, offered this to be the end result.
Right.
Like, God, yo, like...
This shit's been going... Yo, they've been out there for...
20 years,
bro.
2001. We invaded.
When we invaded, bro. Like
2000 fucking one.
We've been out, bro. This is like the longest lasting shit in history.
20-year fucking war for what? And they knew this shit was gonna happen. They just didn't think it was gonna be this fast. And mind you, like I went to Iraq. I went to Iraq, and it's like the way that we train them, they don't fucking care. That's what Biden has been saying. It's like they're not doing shit. It's like we could train them all the fuck we want. They're not. They don't want to fight the fight. They want us to fight their fight, but they have no means. They have no means. Obviously, look at how quick the Taliban took this shit the fuck over.
Right. Yeah, that shit's crazy, bro. I'm watching the news and I'm like, yo, that shit looks insane. Seeing like the videos captured and shit, I'm like, what the fuck is
the fucking president fled the country? Like, they have nothing.
Niggas is fucking scared.
It's bad. It's bad. So now, right now, people are worried about them plotting on, because obviously their agenda is death to America. So people were worried about more attacks on U.S. soil and other places.
That's what I'm worried about. You know what I mean? That's why I'm watching this shit and I'm like, yo, these motherfuckers got full control at this point of a whole entire country. Who knows what else they got full control over? You know what I mean? Yeah. And that's scary. You know what I mean? And you see these motherfuckers, they marching like thousands deep with fucking, everybody got a gun in their hand. Got a gun in their hand.
With our weapons, you could thank Obama for that one.
Yeah. Yeah, I ain't getting deep.
Yeah. That shit get deep.
I know what you mean. Yeah, that shit gets real deep. Hell yeah.
That's why I did want to talk about that. That's all. I came in trying not to. I didn't want to because it really does hit home.
Not for you.
It really does hit home.
Not only that, I forgot that you got a military background. No bullshit. I forgot all about that shit. And I did know that.
Huh?
How old are you?
32. Just turned 32 like last week.
Definitely appreciate you.
I turned 20. Thank you. I turned 20 out there. Like, shit was crazy.
I can't imagine, bro. My dad, the stories my dad told me, bro, he's like, yo, nigga, listen, bro. And he fought the whole first Gulf War, you know what I mean? Desert Storm, he was in Saudi Arabia for a whole year, you know what I mean? Talking about, telling me shitting in holes, watching niggas he was with every day, whole body explode next to him, you know what I mean? Shit like that. Now, his PTSD is different, you know what I mean? I can only imagine yours, you know what I mean? So I'm just like, yo. Man, we gotta just count our blessings, man, for the shit that niggas be like, I'm in the trenches out here, I'm out here in the streets. I'm like, nigga, you don't know about what them niggas out there overseas is going through.
I know. That's why we hate people when people waste water. Like, I hate people waste water. Right. Like, I be peeping, like, all right, you gonna drink all that? Like, all right. Like, that shit bothers the fuck out of me just because I know what it was when we didn't have no water, nigga. We're in the middle of fucking nowhere, we had no water. I remember what it was like having no water in the middle of the desert for days.
Yeah. How long is over there for?
7 months.
Yeah, and that shit's probably just like, what, nigga? No water, nigga? Yeah, I already know, nigga. Shit like that. Yo, bro, but my dad like that too, though, bro. My dad be going through his house, nigga, and he'll pick up empty water bottles and shit, or bottle bottles halfway through. Like, finish smack your shit. Word. Finish your shit, nigga. Word.
Yeah, it'd be like that.
Yo, man, I got some music to send you, though, man. Word. For you to mix down for niggas and shit. Word, I'll be seeing you getting busy. I'll be seeing you spin a lot of records, nigga. It's time for niggas to get back in tune. You already know. But like I said, we doing the
beat that was playing
Monday Madness with Mike Ness.
That I was rocking to. I told him you burned it down. Niggas need you out there, but you know.
You make music?
That's another topic. Nah. You know, I just be like,
nah.
I just be peeping shit.
That's my fucking.
I just be peeping shit. But I don't get paid for it, so I'll acknowledge it. So it ain't going on.
Nah, he a low-key A&R, though. No bullshit.
Word.
Nah.
You got a project coming out? What you plan on doing?
Yo, low-key, me and Ali might got a trick up our sleeve. Some shit the whole city been waiting for.
Word.
Me and Ali been thinking about it, you know what I mean? So maybe we are, maybe we ain't.
Nah, you lying.
But, yeah, man. Maybe we are, maybe we ain't. I mean, we got some shit coming, though. I know I got... Now, I mean, Monday Madness with Mike Neff coming. We're going to do a 10-week streak. So, whatever week it starts to wear.
And we got a different design every week for his 10 weeks. We got designs for days. So
yeah.
Every week he got, we got a different shirt, different hoodie, different hat. It changes every week.
So, how do you guys go about putting out a new drop? Like, y'all come as a collective? And be like, this is it, or no? I understand what you were saying, but like, do you, at the end of the day, say everybody is like, nah, I'm not fucking with it. Are you putting it out any fucking ways?
Mm-hmm. We wear this shit a lot.
Nah, so we don't promote what's not out. So it's all collective. Like, if he's the designer, so he designs it and sends it to us. And we collectively, like, if we feeling it, we gonna drop it. If not, we not. Word. It's That's not about fact. The people at all. We don't give them an option. If we feel it's hot, it's hot. If we drop it, it's hot, period. That's a fact.
Simple as that.
We ain't had no bad drops so far. Not saying we're perfect, and we won't have no bad drops. That's the part of the game, but so far, flawless.
Nah, but, yo.
He's that word.
That's a fact.
Yo, nah. I ain't gonna hold you, man. We're so careful with shit that we put out that we're not gonna put out no bullshit. I promise you that. I can promise.
We got some bullshit in the cut, but
we got some bullshit
people,
in the cut.
The people will never see it, so it doesn't matter. No.
That's yeah, because we got some bullshit in the cut. We got some shit like, oh yeah, we was bugging, man. That shit was like, nah, that wasn't gonna work. But so does every other company, you know what I mean? in this fucking clothing game. But at the same time, our number one genre is just stay organic, man. Stay yourself, man. Don't be nobody else but you.
We're not Republic we're not stands a for trending it. Company. Like, we don't do what's popping at the moment. We do some shit. We drop it today. It's going to be popping next year, next month, 10 years from now. It's like,
yeah,
that's just the way it is. Or,
this t-shirt right here, man, we both wore it for a reason, you feel me? Because this is our classic logo. This is like our main logo that we use. This color or black, whatever. Yo, we got three main colors that we rock with. It's usually red, black, and white. I don't know if niggas noticed that. I'm pretty sure people noticed it, you feel me? But at the same time, what's Gucci's main colors, you feel me? What's Balenciaga's main colors? Balenciaga's main colors, if you pay attention, is black and white.
Yeah, the blue is coming though. Just for the others.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is, people support dope shit. When you're in a certain lane, and when people notice your trend or the way you move and the way your shit is made, like, man, I'm fucking with it. Cause these niggas just stay themselves, and they ain't doing it for the people. They doing it from them, and they people gonna accept it or they don't. You know what I mean? And that's what a lot of people, it's kind of like people who don't got their masters, you know what I mean? Versus people who do have their masters. You know what I'm saying? It's like, nigga, I do what I want. My creative mix is going to go however far we want it to go. And if y'all don't like it, y'all don't like it, but fuck it. As far as somebody else telling you how creative you should be. And ain't nobody about to do that. Like, you know what I mean? That's where we stand at. Like, nobody's going to ever be able to tell us where our creativeness goes, or we should be this creative, or we should do this, or we should do that. Like, nah, if it ain't broke, don't fucking fix it. But we ain't big on too much. Less is more, you know what I mean? And that's just the way we're gonna stay, you feel me? Like, until, nigga, I'm gone, he gone, we gone, this shit is gonna go through the roof, I'm telling you, man.
Nah, it don't even matter, we gone. This shit generational wealth, this shit for the kids, or
word.
We're not even working for us. And this shit all said and done.
Michael Jr. gonna take this shit. Ronnie Jr. gonna take this shit.
We gone. They gonna take it over.
That's what I'm saying. I want this shit to be. Y'all really want this shit to be like boutique level. You know what I mean? Like, yo, man, that's that Infinite Republic shit. You feel me? But there's motherfuckers that's in a real high space, like a real higher space than us. Then it told us, like, yo, the name itself pop, you know what I mean?
It's crazy. Y'all really don't understand. Well, I'm living that, because people really don't know that my father, some people don't know, my father was a DJ, right? But my father used to throw this shit called the Get Ill Picnic every fucking summer. And this shit went on for damn near 10 years. Right. I grew up watching my father putting on festivals, tournaments, all types of shit, DJing every fucking where. And people don't understand where this inspiration comes from. Like, I saw this shit. I saw it. I saw all this. Everything that I'm doing, I saw already as a kid.
Yo,
it's
bro,
like, so you don't even understand. Yo, when you, if you're a creative and you got fucking
you see
kids,
shit before it happens.
They're gonna grow up to be creatives. Ain't no way.
How you feel about how you feel about certain shit, like as far as when it comes to creativeness? Do you feel like, you know, told me yourself, you like, yo, bro, that's too much shit. That's his thing. He always, yo, that's too much, bro. That's too much. And when I send him some simple shit, he love it, you know what I mean? But then when we put it out and we get the results from it, I'm like, all right, I get it, you feel me? And thus far, if you see any of our pieces, by the way, we got a website coming out. Shout out to Hannah Anderson.
Definitely.
You feel me?
Real soon. We're a little late, but at the same time, we right on time, so it ain't going on.
But the website is monstrous. You're going to be able to, and when the website drops, like I said, you can still hit us up directly, but We'd rather y'all go to the website, order up. It should have come right to your doorstep. You feel me? You get a confirmation code. Everything is going to be real official. You feel me? So it ain't got to be no more cash apping, no more Venmo, none of that shit, nothing. If you want something, you see it, check online. If it's available, it's available. If it's not, it's not. Mm-hmm. I'll make it available for you if you want it that bad. You feel me? And then we go from there. Exactly. Word.
Is there anything different you would do looking back in your start?
The only thing I would do different is starting earlier. We should have been to this shit.
Yo.
We would have been did it. We'd have been a little bit further.
Yo, bro.
But I always said we ain't late. We ain't early. We right on time. This is our time, so.
Yo, bro, I ain't gonna front, man. Me and Fats here, we was talking shit to each other probably like fucking a year ago. I'm like, yo, bro, man, we need to get this clothing shit started. He like, yo, bro, man, just let's get it. Let's just do it. Do it, nigga, do it. I'm like, and then finally, nigga, I sat back and I was like, man, I just started sending these niggas shit. I just threw everybody in the group chat and started sending them shit. And they like, all right. And I just made a shirt. Like I told you, I made a shirt. And they was like, yo, nigga, my brother pulled up with me with 5 bands. Like, nigga, go ahead, nigga. Start it. You know what I mean? This shit started with 5 bands, nigga. And now we well over 100 bands in. Like, well over. Like, probably 2 months ago, we've been past 100 bands. You know what I mean? And this shit is really, it's really starting to become something like, nigga, I work for myself. I don't want to work for the excuse. Nothing to the white man, but I ain't never working for the white man again, you feel me? That shit's done with, you feel me? Nigga, we work for ourselves, nigga. This is how it's supposed to be. Just like you work for yourself, right?
Absolutely.
Work for yourself, right? Somewhat.
Ain't nothing wrong with that. Ain't nothing wrong with
it. It's a 50-50. It doesn't matter what color working for.
Get it how you live.
And my situation is a little bit different though, because of the military shit as well.
Oh, word. So,
yeah.
I don't really see myself going back to a 9-to-5 though. Like, I'm not too good for it, nothing like that. But this is my 9-to-5.
Bro. Nah, this nigga went up in the morning.
Hours, just like, it's not paid.
Nah, I ain't gonna front. It's been this. Me, I'm like a family man and shit. You feel me? So I got my kids running around and shit. If it wasn't for Buddha, nigga, I'd be in the hole if it was up to me to get the day started and get everything.
You done purchased some shit, you know who I am. That's a fact. I don't even say too much.
I tell niggas all the time, like, look, if it wasn't for Buddha and shit, if it wasn't for this nigga right here and shit, me, I'd be up, nigga. Nigga, I'm up every day at 6 in the morning and shit, you feel me? That's just from going to the joint, you feel me? That shit just got, my mind is wakes me up like that. But I got kids, too, you feel me? So I get my kids ready to go to they programmed that they fucking daycare, nigga, all types of bullshit that they gotta do during the day. And then when I'm done with that, this nigga Buddha's already fucking 4, 5, 6 cells in. You know what I mean? It's like 9 o'clock. He like, yeah, nigga, I already done sold this to this person. They said they hit you up, Niff. They said you ain't answer, so hit me up. You feel me? And mad niggas like, yo, you know what I mean? Mad niggas will hit me up like, yo, nigga, I hit you up, nigga, like 3 times, nigga. You ain't hit me back, nigga. I hit your man up. I'm like, nigga, I been told you to hit up Buddha, bro. Buddha's the nigga to hit up, bro.
Yeah, I'm the walking website.
Word.
But if you want to hit anybody up, man, just speak to Buddha, bro. I'm telling you, man, because he's going to get to you in rapid speed, rapid time, A1 service, you know what I mean? And you're going to get exactly what you asked for, so don't try to run no game on him or nothing, because he gonna pull up on you. He gonna test your wallet. I'm telling niggas right now. You got, there's been niggas that done said some bullshit and booting them pulled up like, yeah, this nigga bullshit. Yeah. I'm outside the crib right now. Yeah, this nigga lying.
You talk that talk. I'm here to walk that walk.
Yeah, nigga, pull up, nigga. I need 10 shirts.
Oh, boy.
I had niggas say I need 10 shirts. Nigga, them booting them pulled up. Like, yeah, this nigga lying.
Yeah, I've been asked this question a lot lately. Why don't you think older artists in this area take younger artists under their wing?
Springfield. Nigga, because he's in Springfield? Cabin.
Yeah.
Nigga, because money to do it.
Yo, bro. Yo, Matt. I'm going to tell you, artists from artists, nigga. These old niggas don't want to let their fucking reign go, bro. Old ass nigga. Sit your old ass down, nigga. Go get same, a cane, nigga.
Same shit Carlos said. That's real shit.
That or they ain't got no umbrella.
Yo, bro, that's why I fell back. Niggas be asking why Niff fell back. I love music. I'm going to always make music. But nigga, fall back, nigga. Shout out to Reek Lauren. Shout out to T Swan. Shout out to these young niggas that really got the juice, bro. That still got it in them, bro. These niggas be out here still trying to fucking run off of shit that they was doing in like 2010, nigga.
Nah,
like,
it really depends. But how can older niggas, the young niggas now, like, they don't got no code.
That's understandable.
So why would you take a nigga under your wing and he's about to go catch a case? You gotta bail him out. That's just a waste of money, my nigga. Like, you gotta, if you don't got a plan, why the fuck am I gonna take you under my wing because you're good at rapping? Like, I don't care if you're popping.
See, there go Buddha talking that shit.
He ain't bullshitting, though.
These little niggas be on some bullshit.
Yeah, like, that motherfucker like, becomes an asset.
You might want to pick a nigga up, and then nigga got a bunch of bullshit going on.
You gotta be in jail, and that's just my money being wasted.
Facts.
Wow. Could have threw it on the floor.
I don't know, man.
That's a take I can agree with. That it is one hell of a responsibility. Because these kids
you can't control a human being.
You can't be a street guy rapping. That's just everybody says that shit. That's the truth though. You gotta pick what you wanna do.
Nah, you can't be a street guy rapping.
You gonna go pay $50 for your session, you go rap and drop a hot ass verse, and then you going out here catching a real case. So you get popping and niggas like, yo, that song is dumb hot. Where's he at? He's on some jail. He got 90 days to get bail.
Responding to bullshit.
Shout out Pooh Shiesty.
Word.
Pooh Shiesty in the joint right now?
Shout out Pooh Shiesty. He in the joint right now? Shout out Pooh
Shiesty. How long he got?
He's a dumbass.
Mm-hmm. What Pooh Shiesty in the joint for?
For fucking shooting at his concert. He was shooting himself. Like, why do you have pay security and you're shooting?
What did he shoot?
That is some dumb shit.
What did he shoot, nigga?
What did he shoot? What the
fuck?
Oh, no, he shot. What, he had a dart gun?
No. I'm saying, what was he shoot at somebody?
Yeah.
As he dropped cash or some shit like that. I'm not sure.
Either way, he won.
Somebody said he dropped cash and then he
paid niggas to protect him and was still shooting at niggas.
Allegedly.
So he lost money both ways. He paid security.
Allegedly, Pooh Shiesty
and lawyers.
Allegedly,
and he missing out on shows.
He's allegedly the dumb.
And those are contracts too. So more money.
Yo, bro, that makes no sense to me. Yo, bro, it's easy for us to say that though, because we ain't got that type of money.
Man, listen, I had more cops than 50 Cent around this motherfucker.
Bro, I ain't gonna front. Yo,
nigga, they'll have to check you.
You not walking around how much cash?
Talk about you better have your ID if I get that type of money.
Yo, bro, I ain't gonna front.
I'm not having a
shit.
Cop, so
say what you wanna say.
Walking around with that much cash on me.
My kids got diamonds and ponies and.
My dad's an officer. You feel me?
Hold up.
Go ahead. My dad been in this type of shit since I was a kid, though.
Shout
you know
out to
what
the
mean?
Big dog.
Shout out to the big dog, Tony Gibbs, nigga. CTG, nigga. Cool, Tony Gibbs. Word. Nigga,
you might catch a pass.
But, nigga, you might catch a pass if you drop his name. Nah, but he one of them cops, you know what I mean? He ain't a dickhead cop, you know what I mean? Nigga, he. In this shit, to win this shit, on some looking out for the brothers. You feel
bro
me?
Bro was like, that nigga had when I needed him.
Yo, look, we ain't gonna do this right now.
Nigga, been
look.
In Chickabee trouble a couple times, nigga.
Nah,
fuck.
This nigga known by all of them.
Shout out my pops though, man.
Nigga,
a lot of people don't know that about me, but nigga, my pops is gonna tell me just like he tell everybody else, man. Like, nigga. Life is what you make it, nigga, you know what I mean? People gonna judge him for being a cop just like people gonna judge me for being who I am. Just like people gonna judge Torch for what Torch do. Jay gonna judge B for who B is, you feel me? People out here gonna judge you regardless, you feel me?
Bang the
for game. Every profession is, whatever you choose to do. But what Infinite Public stand for is infinite, you feel me? Be infinite in whoever the fuck you are. Be organic. If you a fucking geek, be the fucking most infinite geeky.
Facts,
if
though.
If you a gangster, be the most infinite gangster you could be. If you
niggas
a fucking
is not authentic
rapper,
like
be the
that,
most
yo.
Infinite rapper you could be, nigga.
Niggas
if
is not
DJ,
authentic anymore, yo.
Be the most infinite fucking DJ you could be, nigga. Be authentic. Be organic. Be you. That's what our brand run
That's
off
it,
of.
Dope.
It's about being
That's
you. It, just being who you are. And being infinite to that shit. You feel me?
Fire.
For real. Straight like that. Like, don't be nothing else but who the fuck you are. And that's why, nigga, me and Buddha, nigga, we like fucking water and oil, nigga. He know that, nigga. It's my right-hand man, though. You know why? Because he teaches me the shit that I need to be taught, just like I teach him the shit he need to be taught. Nigga, we feed off each other, you feel me? It's never a bad day with this man. You know why? Because, nigga, he understands me, and I understand him. I understand who he is, and he not trying to be nobody but who he is. And I ain't trying to be nobody but who I am, you feel me? And once niggas soon to understand that shit, then niggas will be like that. You know the Antoine Walker syndrome? Mm-hmm. I'm going to tell you the Antoine Walker syndrome. Antoine Walker was fucking gambling with Michael Jordan. Antoine Walker and Michael Jordan. Just think about that. You know what I mean? So, nigga, these niggas are gambling. Antoine Walker is betting the same shit Michael Jordan betting. He's losing. Mike losing too. Mike don't care he lost. I'm Michael Jordan, nigga. But nigga, you're Antoine Walker, nigga. So when you go home, you feel me? So when you go home, nigga, your significant other gonna be a little bit more upset than mine is. You feel me? Basically, stay in your fucking lane, nigga. Be who you are, nigga, and nigga, and be true to that shit. Don't be Antoine Walker.
Simply put,
bro, Michael Jordan's a billionaire, bro. Antoine Walker was just playing in the CBA.
You know what I'm saying? Hold on. You just talk money wise. I like how my boy used to ball. He get out there just gunning.
Yeah, Antoine Nice.
You know what I mean? That was J.R. Smith before J.R. Smith. You feel me?
Nah, but still,
he don't care if it was the truth or the lie. He was shooting for 30. Yeah. That's my
Antoine
man.
Walker be betting the same shit.
Not at all.
That Michael Jordan's betting.
Not at all.
No, bro. Stay in your lane, bro. Michael Jordan bet 50K, nigga, you bet 3, nigga.
Oh, my God.
Yo,
if you being real, 1,500. No, 1,500.
Bro, I done been out. Yo, bro, we done all been out with niggas who had more money than us. And seen them do more money shit.
No bullshit. Wow,
more
shit.
Money shit.
You buying two like, bottles tonight it's just, from the club?
Depends on the
nigga,
person.
You know what they put? You know. Nah, nigga, that shit, bro. I'm just saying. Nigga.
Depends on the person. Are you comfortable in your skin? None of that bothers you.
No. I'm talking about as far as we done been around niggas that, like, all right, that nigga's doing that.
Right, you can't do what he doing. Right.
But that's not what I do.
Let me get a piece of it.
Yeah, nigga, let me get a cup. Or, nigga, I'm going to go to the bar and I'm going to get me another drink because I'm not buying that $300 bottle tonight, nigga, because that's not in my means, nigga. And it's okay to say that.
Yeah, I don't be doing that.
Know they shouldn't be doing it, that do it anyways, and then go home and got to explain to their bitch why the rent is short or why the kids.
Tell Greg come next week.
Because you done spent Wi-Fi money on fucking Rosé,
nigga. Nah, yo.
Take the bitch ass home,
nigga.
You know you tell motherfucker come next week.
That's
you
fucked up.
Mommy, why you come like from America connected? Yeah. Daddy spent Coco Melon money on Rosé.
That's fucked up.
He was with Dion and them niggas. And he was trying to keep up.
That's fucked up. It be like that,
it
though.
It be like that.
Antoine Walker syndrome. That's what I call it. Biggest. Stay in your fucking lane, nigga.
Biggest bro, dope nigga. Beat. That shit
be
is hilarious.
Be organic, man. Y'all that love this show, man. Y'all got me wet, too. I like that. Word. Nah. That's what I'm saying. This shit organic, nigga.
Word. I thought you was about to give him a 32 right there with that. Nah. Y'all done fucked up now.
That shit is dope as fuck. I always appreciate this shit.
Yeah, man.
Mm-hmm.
How much of...
Yo, Mac, your eyes got low.
Yo, high, nigga. How much of being an artist did that help transition into what you had to do to... Do what you
yo,
need
bro.
To bring.
Yo, bro, I ain't gonna front, man. That shit was me. I'm a marketing. These niggas call me, yo, bro, you the marketing genius. You feel me? But with that being said, is I take what I know and what I know that I have the power of and use it. You know what I mean? I know that people pay attention to me. Even if you don't think I know you pay attention to me, I know you do. You know what I mean? So I take that shit and I use it to my advantage. So I'm like, all right, nigga, I ain't been making music like that, but the people that know me for making music still pay attention to me. Mm-hmm. So let me throw these clothes in here real quick. Let me see how they react to it. Once I seen the reaction to it, I'm like, all right, let me throw my peoples in the midst of it. You know what I mean? Everybody hit boot up now. Niggas don't hit me up no more. That's a fact though. They like, all right, Niff, you kind of like made it clear that you're not dealing with me and to hit up boot. But I ain't saying it like that, but it's the truth though, you know what I mean?
That's fire.
But
I know exactly what you're talking about.
My brother said it earlier, he like, yo, nigga, you take me on my comfortability, but I like that shit. You know what I mean? But what I mean by that is it's because, nigga, he's the coolest nigga I know. You know what I mean? And I'm like, yo, bro, saw some of this cool on some of these niggas when you run into them because they need it. You know what I mean? So now niggas is hitting me up like, yo, I met your man Buddha, man. Your man Buddha cool as fuck, man. Where the mother, this, and that. You feel me? And I'm like, see, bro, I told you. You know what I mean? But it's like, man, this shit is fun, man. And it's man, his t-shirt made it the furthest. Shout out to the Ron Buddha t-shirt, by the way. Word. Or the other way. Shout out to the Ron Buddha t-shirt, by the way. Yo, my man t-shirt.
Fire.
Yo, bro, my man t-shirt made it all the way to the Dominican Republic, bro. All the way to DR, bro. His shit all the way in DR, bro. Nigga, ain't no other shirt made it that far so far. His shit was a DR. You know what I mean? So, we gonna keep this off the, you know what I mean? There's a story behind the shirt. Just know it's a shirt.
Try.
Shit about nothing.
Right.
I don't do nothing besides Infinity Republic.
Right.
You don't know me from nothing else.
Nothing else.
If you think you do, you mistaken me.
That's his twin.
That's his twin, Ron Butter.
Got the game fucked up out here.
His name is Ron Butter, and this is Ron Buddha.
And let's put this on record. Let my baby mamas know that I ain't get my percentage yet. Don't watch this shit get happy. You know.
He said for the record.
I'm like an intern. I'm like an intern. I just get my shirts on time and, you know, just make it look good.
Nah, man, but shout out to the Ron Buddha team and made it all the way to DR, man.
Definitely.
That shit is
dope. Nah, we out here. Word. If you need one, yo, just contact me. I'll get it to you at a fashionable time. Word. That's about it. I ain't got too much to say, like I told you.
You wear a medium too?
Yeah.
All right, I'm making sure.
And if you know you ain't got your 220, stop getting in that man inbox like that.
No, that's cool.
She sent me the sizes over here. She sent me a double XL for her. I was like, hold up, my nigga. Carla sent me a double XL. She was like, for me, double XL. She was like, for Mac, some XLs. And nigga, for, I'm like, hold up, you got these sizes a little fucked up. Shout out to Sis, man. I wish she was here.
Nah, it was crazy last minute, too. It was crazy. I was on my way when I got the message that she couldn't
make
it.
Nah, bro, I'll be going up to her gig, man. That's me and Shorty's favorite spot. No bullshit. Y'all been up there?
Yeah, I've been up there once. What? Yeah. Yeah, that food was good as fuck.
That shit lit as fuck, man.
I was drunk as hell, too. Good as fuck.
I was in there drinking tequila. I was showing my ass.
Yo, how do y'all feel about entitled ass motherfucking artists out here?
What you mean? Yo, bro.
What you mean?
I have point,
a perfect
like
example.
One. Yeah, say his name. I don't give a fuck. Say his
name. That's cool then.
The Executive.
Cool. I heard of him.
Yeah. This is supposed to be somebody I was really like, all right,
yo,
kind of cool with.
You know what's crazy? Me and him battle back in the
days. Yeah,
act
like I wasn't going to say this nigga's name. Well, I was going to say
him
this
nigga's
name.
Me and him battle back in the days
at
Mass Cat.
Ready.
I was like 16. He had like 37 niggas with him. I had like 3 white boys with him. So they all like hyped up the shit in the... He ended up winning. I'll give him that. But then...
So he smoked you?
No. He didn't smoke me. But career-wise, like when it comes to like... niggas know who the fuck Mike Niff is. You know what I mean?
A little rematch.
I fuck with dude. And that's what makes me so upset about this shit.
Yeah, but on the flip side... Yo, On the flip side, executive is a decent artist, but
quicker to get out.
I get what you say when you say what you said. And Mike, you know me.
This nigga is upset. I don't even know why he mad. I still don't know why he mad. But when you dip, just be careful with the camera. All I know is that this nigga's upset that I didn't play his music at Splitfield. I got a crazy text message.
Oh,
he don't want to come on the podcast.
One of those happened.
He don't want to come on the podcast no more.
Was he supposed to play it or was it?
Nah,
it wasn't playing.
Nah, none of that. He asked me if I heard his music. I told him that day I didn't open the email, so he knew I didn't have it right then and there.
So I was supposed to listen to it and just put it on.
I guess.
Was I supposed to just play that shit?
I guess.
Because what?
I guess. I don't know. I just looked at this shit and I sent it to the group and I was all the way mad. It's like nigga,
set me up, Torch.
Nah, I'm not setting nobody up. This is between obviously the two of us. But it's like
Nah. I fuck with the executive, but
me too. Well, I thought I did.
Listen, man. If nigga ain't play your shit, he ain't play it.
And that's the shit. There was mad artists there that didn't play their music. Like right. I could name you. I could name the artist that was there that didn't play their music.
They ain't send no text.
Nah.
It happens.
It's like because I play y'all music all the time. I play y'all music all the time. Duncan and Creep came on. Mind you, they already been on the podcast. They had their own For the Culture shit. It's like we already did mad shit for y'all. Like what else do you want me to?
Right.
Just because you're in the building? No, that's not how this shit works.
Nah.
That's not how it works. Even after I told you I didn't open your email, I told you that day I didn't open your email, my nigga. I told you to your face that day. I did not open.
Meaning it's not on the schedule.
I did not open that email.
So that was totally. You should have nothing to feel bad about. That's I just see things black and white. That's why people don't like me. You know what I mean? It's black and white. It's black or white. It's no middle color. You didn't open the email, meaning I didn't hear the song. So how I know to play the song?
Respectfully, fam. I didn't open your email.
Nah, fuck all that. You ain't gotta add all that. I didn't open the email. I didn't listen to it. Wouldn't you want me to sit down and take a good listen? Like I'm supposed to listen to this shit on my computer real quick and then throw it on? Like that's crazy. Nah, that's crazy.
That's
you gotta.
Not how this shit work?
People gonna be looking at you some type of way if it's whack.
Yo, Torch, that's not how it work. Yo, Torch, I know how you. Yo, bro, that's what I want to ask you, bro. Cause I had a few questions I want to ask you.
It was good.
Yo, how does that feel to be on that platform?
That's
to be
rough.
In charge of playing niggas' new shit.
That's rough.
And you don't play niggas' new shit.
And they hot.
They get like this.
Yo, bro.
Yo, bro. You notice I ain't saying that, right? Yo, Torch was live. That's how I know Torch up with me. Torch was live. I was sending Torch shit. Torch was playing that shit as I was sending it to him.
Yo.
Like the game up now. Niggas about to be fast.
He's playing. Yeah.
See? Torch, come on, man. He put the... See? Now what you said... Yo, oh, boy, really going to be hot. Like, what you said? The executive? What was it?
Yeah, the exec.
Torch now he really going to be mad.
On For the Culture Friday, if I'm live, no bullshit, there's a few people that I would do that for. I ain't doing that for every fucking body. Okay. I'm choosy as fuck at this point. Yo, bro, you asking me, that's the honest answer. I'm choosy as fuck.
Bro. I sent him two drinks and he played both of them.
I'm choosy.
That shit was a while ago, but he really did, bro. And
I'm choosy.
You know, am I lying, bro?
Nah.
I sent you two drinks and he played both
I'm
of them.
Choosy.
Shit, that shit was dope, bro.
And then, yo, but even like that, I was, in my, I bought weed off this nigga at Splitfield. Mind you, I'm waiting in line to get my fucking weed from this nigga. And some shit was playing. Nobody knew what the fuck it was. And For the Culture shit. It's like... What is playing? I had no idea the artist, what song title. I had no idea. I was like, this shit is trash. Get this shit the fuck out of here. So when it comes to being the one in control, like, nah, yo, the shit I play, trust me, is good. It's good. I'm not playing no whack shit. When I do play the whack shit, the lives go all the way the fuck down. Nah, we're not on live right now. This is all gonna be pre-recorded. It's gonna go up on YouTube. Afterwards, yeah. But nah, niggas don't be. Nah, I'm selective as fuck. I listen to. I gotta vet it at this point. I have so much
as
of it now.
As you should be, as part of your job.
Yeah.
Yo, bro. I can only imagine.
I be getting some like trash. I be like.
Yo, bro. I can only imagine the records you get, and you like, bro. All right, my nigga. Like.
But right. That's the shit though too. Even if I don't like it, even if I personally don't like it, I understand the masses, and I understand what other crowds would also like too. Right, so I'm gonna play certain
some
of those records.
Vibe from it, like, all right, I don't like it, but other niggas might like it. But if you get the vibe, like, it's trash. Nobody's gonna like this shit. This
I'm
trash.
Definitely not playing
it's not
that
getting
shit.
No burn.
There's it's artists that send me music that won't hear it. They won't. You will not. You will not.
But that's part of your job.
You will not hear.
You can't go to the liquor store and get mad that the lady cards you. That's part of her job.
Right.
You know
right.
what I mean? So you can't just be sitting anything. You know what I mean?
Nah. Yeah. Gonna but get then there's like some it. Artists that I respect, and it's like I think their shit is alright. They got a following. I'll play their shit like once or twice, just out of their respect. Like, but then if I
ain't gonna say no names. Love. A lot of artists that I just feel yeah. get too much credit for the credit they get that they shouldn't be getting.
Some I know, say some names. Say some names. That's good. Cool. Niggas be dropping names.
I ain't saying
names.
No names.
Yeah,
we
be dropping names.
We
come here for that.
What's going on? I don't even know their names no more.
We come here for that. Shout out to the Infinite Republic.
Why you gonna open Pandora box and close it back up?
Is that something that you're looking for? You looking for brand ambassadors? Is that anything that you?
Yo, we're looking for fly ladies, man. That one, that. Now, I mean, it ain't about showing ass and showing titties and none of that. It's about coming out, know what I mean, and just, know what I mean, really looking good, know what I mean, and trying to show the brand off. If we find a woman that could look good in all our shit, and know what I mean, and be, like, real down to earth and really be down for us, then, nigga, you could be part of the team.
How you pronounce fat shit again? How you pronounce that shit?
Alex for sure.
Word.
Shout out to Alex for sure. Yo. By the way, man, now the to my own horn, I created all the designs for that too. You
know, oh, shit.
Word, man, I've been fucking.
You designed a lot of shit low key, but
yeah.
I'm not here for that.
Mm. Word, I mean.
Yeah.
I mean, not my niece. I designed for my niece for a crown top, a few things I designed for.
Where'd that come from? You've always been like designing clothes. You always thought about design and shit?
The thing with me, man, is. I had a feel for it like a few years ago and shit, but it wasn't, nigga, I wasn't comfortable with it. I wasn't confident. And then I started sending a few things off to my peoples and shit, and they was like, that shit dope. But I knew it wasn't dope like that, you know what I mean? But your fucking niggas is always gonna tell you, like, nigga, work on this, work on that, work on this, work on that, work on this, work on that. But as the fucking time went past, I started realizing, like, yo, nigga, I'm kind of nice, nigga. I'm working on this, I'm working on that. And I sent Buddha shit. Buddha, like, yo, nigga, this shit kind of better than the last two shits you sent me. I sent Buddha some more shit. He's like, yo, this shit better than the last two shits you sent me before that. And then I sent Buddha some more shit. Now he's like, yo, nigga, you nice, nigga. You feel me? Now niggas is hitting me up, and I'm sending niggas work, and they paying me for it. And they like, yo, this shit is dope, nigga. You know what I mean? Now I got, nigga, I make, like, $300-$400 a week, nigga. A good week, I make $500. A bad week, I make $200. But I make at least $200 a week off my images and, like, off of people from just the city, nigga. If it's flyers, if it's a fucking logo, if it's a fucking birthday card, nigga, a fucking baby shower invitation. I don't care what it is. Niggas is hitting me up for something, you feel me? But that wasn't my passion, bro. I'm gonna be honest, nigga. I didn't know what I was doing at first. I just started fucking with shit, and it came together. My mans told me probably 2 months ago, nigga, like, nigga, don't give up. I ain't gonna disclose his name because he one of those kind of niggas, you feel me? But he was like, yo, bro, nigga, don't give up, nigga. I see this shit going somewhere, nigga. So shout out to that nigga. He know who he is, nigga. He gonna watch this shit.
All right. I seen some crazy shit. What are the rules of when you see another nigga throwing cash in a club? Are you the type of nigga to pick it up?
What you mean?
Are you type of nigga to pick up another nigga's cash that he threw?
Now listen, the only way I'm gonna ever pick up another nigga cash,
that's a little crazy,
is he's throwing $100 bills.
There's no limit to that.
And I don't give a fuck.
I agree with that.
Say what you want. Call me whatever.
I'll snap my damn self grabbing them shit. Got about 1,500 fucking with him.
Yo, bro, you're not
picking
up
$100
bills?
Yeah.
You're not? Yo, bro.
Right, yeah. He tried to sit over there like he wasn't going to pick that shit up.
So hold up. So y'all not picking no $100 bills up?
I think I'm picking up $100.
All right, now. That boy paying car insurance and all of that.
I think I'm definitely picking up $100 bills.
At least a couple.
You got to slide that.
You gonna be mad when you get in the car.
Slide.
The Usher bar.
No shame in my game. I'm down there.
That's crazy. I ain't never seen no shit like that.
If they on my clothes, I'll take them off and keep them. If they drop them on the floor, I'm not picking them up.
Oh, nah. I mean,
well, you stay there, Mr. Cool.
Yo, listen.
I'll tell you right now. You're going to be eating some seafood off the motherfuckers the next day. You're going to be with me, right?
It's going to be me and B. You're gonna be me and B going to have 20K.
Gas on me.
Me and B going to have 20K.
Oh, my God.
Yo, bro, I don't give a fuck.
Crazy. $100 bill?
Bro, you throw $100 bill.
You're fighting bitches.
You're
for the
wild. Call me whatever you want, bro.
Move your little thin edges out the way.
Bro,
I'm sitting
next to the dickhead nigga throwing $100 bills.
You got
to
push a whole girl on the floor for that $100 bill.
Yo,
Torch. Nah, I get it, like.
It's a doggy dog.
Like I said, I get it. I'm not against her.
Sorry,
but
you know what? You leave your part on the floor. Yeah. I'm gonna come grab your part.
Yeah.
This nigga said, if it fall on me, that's how it's gonna start. You know what I mean? Shit.
Oh my God.
$100 bro. Yo, bro, Torch. Your Torch, you in the club right now, right?
You just get the car started because it's going to be a lot of mad bitches.
Yo, Torch.
That's what you do. I'm going to get my buddy.
Stupid.
You just get the car started. Since you don't want to grab nothing, get the car started. I'm going to have at least 10 bitches chasing me. I'm going to trip for four of them. Shit, $100 bills. Who is this nigga? He need to come out more often. Shit. $100 bills. I don't care if I got it. I'm not throwing $100 bills. I go in there and get 400 ones and,
yo,
you know what I mean, take 200 out at a time.
Yo, bro, so if a nigga got $1,500 bills, right, 100 of them, and he just throwing them shits is all just falling all in front of you.
Randy Moss.
Nah, yo, no bullshit. I don't know, nigga.
Boy, you be Larry Fitzgerald out there.
I've seen that shit and I did it.
Nobody's dying.
I've seen that shit and I did it.
We ain't dying for him. I've never seen it.
I was in San Diego.
I'm not lying, nigga. I done been.
You gonna do it, but you gonna do it in a cool way.
You gonna do it in a cool way.
I was in Miami, nigga, in Madonna with Larry Fitzgerald actually throwing bills, but he wasn't throwing hundreds.
Nah, I was in San Diego, and this nigga literally, yeah, this nigga was, yeah, he was a white, random ass white boy. I didn't, but like, he was, I was like, oh shit, everywhere.
Oh, nah, he's wild. Nah,
everywhere. It was 100% of floss.
Mono said it happened to
and
him.
people went crazy.
Who, Jay Mono?
Yeah.
Nah, Jay Mono was shooting the.
He said y'all keep a few. What?
Nah, he got bagged. You really say got yo? He had the fucking guns.
Yeah.
You feel me?
He had a gun.
But what I'm saying is, one of them shooting shit. Hundreds out the gun.
Yeah.
I had guns before, but I was shooting ones. I ain't gonna front. That's what you're supposed to shoot.
I'm damn sure I ain't shooting twos.
I'm not shooting.
Tell you that.
I'm not shooting fives. I'm not shooting tens.
He getting
fives.
These ones. You gonna get this work.
What are you shooting?
Getting these ones. That's good. What's going on. Somebody throwing hundreds.
Absolutely right.
I'm not doing none of that.
I'm shooting
nothing. I'm keeping my money to myself.
You keeping it to yourself?
I'm not doing none of that.
You ain't grabbing hundreds?
I guess I'm a trick.
I'm not doing none of that.
I done paid my cell phone bill last night.
Yo, no bullshit. I wasn't even I was thinking about something today. I saw recently. I completely forgot about the San Diego shit until right now.
Any nigga says on any yo, nigga, fuck nigga, nip grabbing it. Bro, a nigga throwing $100 bills. Mm-hmm. Them shit's landing all over.
I don't even like people, so I ain't worry about that. What are you talking about, nigga? Well, I'ma hear y'all.
I need all of those. Every single one.
Damn, sure ain't worried about hearing y'all. Nigga, dumbass, nigga. I'll be right in the car. Like, y'all should have got down there.
Y'all should have got down. No, nigga, you know.
I got at least four bands.
No crab legs for you tonight, nigga.
Nah, I'm still getting crab legs. I'm just going to talk shit while they bring them out. No crab legs. See what getting down got me? Peel the shrimp off for him. Peel them for him. Peel them for him. Get you right, you feel me? I'm gonna get you right.
Straight to the bar, get 101s, do the same thing.
Peel the shrimp off.
Now me, bro, that's crazy. That's the Sagittarius in me. I'll take all that shit and go spin it back.
We out here.
One.
Look at A Mon. This a plus. Hey, y'all niggas.
Now for real, nigga. Y'all done seen niggas throw fives, 20s. I ain't seen hundreds yet. I've been to the most major strip clubs in the fucking country, bro. I ain't gonna front. I ain't seen hundreds yet.
That's a little while later.
It was in the middle of the club. It wasn't at a strip club. It was in the middle of the club.
Oh, right. A little quick, though. A little rain.
Like I said, if I nigga seen nigga, that's the only reason I'm saying what I'm saying, because I ain't never been a thirsty nigga for no bread. A nigga shooting hundreds, nigga. All right, nigga. You shooting hundreds? All
right. Hold up. You shooting hundreds. I'm dehydrated as hell.
The first three that fly by, you like, shooting
what you say, y'all? You see how you get mad about water? I get mad about money getting shot out around like that. You know what I mean?
You like, nah, bro. This nigga's disrespecting
money. Wasting these $100 bills like this. Yo, I got somewhere to do something with them.
Yo, Mac, bro. Tell me I'm right, bro.
All these bills I got to be paid.
Next to you start shooting $100 bills. Them shit's all falling right next to you. And you looking at them fall, and nobody else see them shits falling but you.
Oh, man.
You like, man, I'm taking these shits.
Hey, he crazy as hell. That's not me. Them shits ain't never going to have a better friend. They ain't going to get the fall.
There's a little petty thousand. That's it. Petty, that's petty money.
Y'all niggas.
Petty thousand, that's a solo mission.
It's solo mission.
Susan, hit the air is for everybody. They come for that.
Nah, that's too much.
It's like he said, you see 2-3 of them shits flying past you. You notice her vibrating. You're like, whoa.
That's what I'm saying, bro. That's not normal. Bro, I don't give a fuck what strip club you've been to in America.
I'm getting more rebounds than Dennis Rodman.
When you see $100 bills,
I'm getting more boards than Rodman.
That's not normal. No.
0 points, 28 boards.
That nigga was bugging in there.
Like, hold up,
but that's that shit, too, though. Like, I said I didn't, but I realized too late. Like, I realized way too late.
Missed the opportunity.
Because I'm not grabbing no money. My first thing wasn't, I'm not grabbing no money. Somebody throwing that shit.
Yeah.
And then once I realized, damn, that nigga was throwing hundreds. He was doing what?
That's why you need a friend like me. You would have knew. You would have knew after the second bill without what was going on, because I would have left your ass over there.
Nah, no bullshit.
I've been right next to Becky and shit. All right.
My first instinct, I'm not grabbing.
All right. That's the hotel room, the flight, all that right there.
I'm not
Yo, bro. Yo, bro. You know why I don't give a fuck? It's because that nigga that's throwing it is a dumb nigga. So
nigga,
he's stupid, nigga.
The nigga recording while this nigga, he done scraped a cold band.
Hey, that's what I'm sacrificing. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm sacrificing.
Hey, who got a QP?
Come on, my nigga.
That's what I'm sacrificing. You feel me? Play your role. I'm playing my role. You feel me? All right, Scotty. All right, Scotty.
It's
cool.
Oh, no. I'm not diving for nothing.
That's what's going to be when nigga push you over.
Nigga, Odell, three-finger, dive in the back of the corner.
I'm talking about a nigga next to me.
Caesar out there
bills.
Just.
And Bill's just landing on me and landing in front of me and all that. Bro, you're bugging, bro.
Nah. Security gonna carry me out when I got mine. Tell you that right now.
My feet and all that, them shit's coming home, bro.
Yeah, have me jacked up. Call I'm gonna be counting and shit.
Fuck. Nah. I don't give a fuck. There's none of you motherfuckers rich. So I think that's the only time I'll be.
Yeah.
And I'm not picking these shits up.
That nigga was with mad bitches too.
Yeah, bro.
They wasn't going with me. So they was already set to go somewhere. They wasn't going with me. So why I'm not grabbing the money? They was not going with me. It don't matter. My budget is nowhere near his. They was not going with me. Them bitches already had a destination.
I was out with three that night, but then this I look back and I just I was like, oh, god damn.
You would have got a couple extra dollars, you'd have afford four. Okay. You've been like him. Budget. Nah,
military Mike. Nigga didn't get two fucks back then.
Military Mike.
Yeah, I was military Mike.
He said military Mike. Nah. All jokes aside, though. If a nigga throwing some money on some groupie shit, all over niggas and shit, way. I'm diving for no fucking bread. Yeah, but if you're throwing $100 bills and those shits are falling on top of me and in my vicinity,
$100 bills. I don't. I consider that that's opportunity just in the air. You know.
I'm grabbing blue bills, bro. Them shit is falling next to me. Shit. What is wrong with you, stupid nigga? The fuck? You acting like it be the nigga who tried to just through the roof. Fuck nigga, I know.
That's that Leo shit.
I'm grabbing that money. Fuck nigga.
That's that Leo shit.
It be the same.
I'm Aquarius. Everybody need water.
It be the same nigga that.
Everybody need water. All y'all niggas don't survive without me. So therefore, that's my part. I got to get
it. Yo, bro, that same nigga that night getting a 4 for 4. Mad as fuck.
I'm getting a 10 for 10. Y'all niggas getting a 4 for 4.
The same nigga that night who didn't want to pick up them
pockets
bills,
is them right.
Bills falling next to his feet.
Dumb, funny.
The 4 for 4. Go ahead, nigga. Have fun.
Get you 20 of those. That's
this
an excellent night.
Nigga who's trying to show out. I don't care. I made 600 off of him. And call me what you want. Call me what you want, nigga. I need the 6, nigga.
Or he's bugging.
Shit coming home, nigga. Stupid. He even fucked 600 bitches tonight, nigga.
It's crazy.
Nah, for real. Yo, bro, that shit makes no sense to me, though, bro. Yo, bro, I never fucked a bitch off of bread. I never fucked a bitch off of showing off, you know, like that. I always fucked the bitches off of
for free
who I was. That's what I'm saying. That's why I say that's goofy shit. That's why I say I'm comfortable with my own skin to say I'm picking up $100 bills that fall on the floor after my feet because I'm not rich, nigga. And my fucking rent needs to be paid and other shit be paid. And other niggas ain't gonna say that. You know why? Because niggas ain't comfortable with their own skin. You know why? Because niggas ain't organic. That's what Infinite Republic fucking runs off of. Organicness. Nigga, that shit fall on my
microphones
feet.
Today.
Yo, Mac, you got $500 bills next to your feet. A nigga still letting them shits rain. And you see them shits? Nigga, you picking them up, nigga.
They already in his stupid pocket. Nigga. You know what I mean? Y'all just cool. It's all right. Y'all cool, but them dark club lights.
No. But it's the truth, though. It's the truth. But any nigga who comes in his own skin. It's just next to your feet and you look down. Picking them up.
Cool as shit. And then the nigga's so cool that he gonna say he ain't pick shit up. He'll get in the car and say he ain't pick shit up. I wish I would pick some money up. He got like $700 on him. Wish the fuck I would. I'm a grown ass man. I'm a grown ass man.
He got 2 stacks on him. He like, nigga, I
that's
all right.
Anybody know? Your weed man gonna know. When you get there.
Real quick.
Let me get an ounce today. You was picking some of that money up. What? You know you a quarter, nigga. You ain't this motherfucker. You was picking some of that money. It's all right.
Nah, but no bullshit. The whole point of the joke, nigga. The whole point of the joke is to make niggas feel comfortable in their own skin. It's the whole Antoine Walker syndrome I was talking about. All that shit, bro. Like, nigga, stay in your lane, bro. Like, stop doing shit for other niggas, bro. Like, you ain't gotta do shit for nobody else. Do shit for yourself, bro. You are who you are, and you are who you are because of who you are, bro. Simple as that. Like, nigga, you don't gotta keep up with this nigga because his bag is bigger. You gotta keep up with this nigga because his flow is better. You gotta keep up with this nigga because he can do this better than you. That's not how it works, bro. You are who you are. Nigga, master what you the best at. Simple as that. You don't gotta feel no sort of way because niggas do this and you can't do it. You ain't gotta feel no sort of way because niggas do this and you can't do it, nigga. Simple as that. That's why I'm Niff, nigga, and everybody in the fucking city respects me because I'm never fucking scared to be Niff, nigga. These niggas are scared to be them. They scared. You scared, nigga? You scared to get a fucking dog. Simple as that, bro. Simple as that.
You ain't bullshit,
that's some real shit.
You ain't bullshit,
though. You're gonna get a fucking dog, nigga.
Get a dog or a gun.
Get a dog or a gun, nigga.
Call 5-0. You can call loose, ain't you?
Or call 5-0, nigga.
All right, Mrs. Smurda.
Or call
the police. You get kind of loose.
Or call the police.
I do not know this man.
Call 911. They'll help you out. Nah, man. Shout out to any fucking Property Ivy, nigga.
Word.
The fucking shit, nigga.
Word.
Word, nigga. Shout out to my nigga Max. Shout out to Mike Torch.
Thank
nigga.
You. Drop Word. Your social media one time before we get out of here.
Word. Yo, yes, man.
I'm Ron Buddha everywhere. Instagram is Ron Buddha 413.
Word. Catch me on what you catch them on. You understand me? You feel me? You know what I mean? Listen, I don't want that responsibility on my page. You know, B, you ain't put the shirt, you ain't repost the shirt. So, catch me what you catch them on. You understand me?
Yo, man, shout outs on Instagram, man, Infinite Republic Clothing.
Right.
Shout out on fucking Facebook, Infinite Republic Clothing.
Mm-hmm.
Shout me out on Facebook at Mike Niff, MIC, space NIF.
Right.
Shout me out on Twitter, Mike Niff, MICNIF, nigga. Shout me out on all the social medias at Mike Niff. Shout out Ali Fats, nigga, on everything. Word. Ali Fats. ALIPHATTZ. Shout out Aunt G. Shout out T-Bayman. I mean, and nigga, we out here, nigga. Right. Shout out to the motherfucking gang. Shop with the motherfucking bros. If you ain't shop yet, nigga, we got what you want.
Shout
we got
with
what
the
we
creatives.
Got. Yeah, shout out to the fucking creatives. Word. Shout out to Crown Top. Shout Word. Out to the fucking For the Culture.
Word.
Yes. Nigga. And For shout out to Hall time. Of Fresh.
Shout out Hall of Fresh. Word.
Word. Word. Definitely Word. Big shout out to Hall of Fresh. Yeah, I forget my guy.
Fire man. Joints. Too, we needed them finished.
Shout out to my
Right.
son, 010 Fortiola.
Yeah.
Shout out to Fortiola. I don't care what. I fuck with the nigga. I don't care what niggas talking about.
Yeah, word.
Shout out to Yola, I guess.
Yeah, yeah, that's my guy.
Shout out that boy, Yola.
Yeah, shout out Yola.
Why you do Yola like that?
I know. Yeah, yeah.
Nah, he know what he doing, nigga.
I know. Shout out to Chris Joel with the hub.
Man. Word.
Yeah. Shout out to the editor you got to do.
Nah, yeah, ain't no editor. We don't edit shit. We never
edit shit, nigga. I raw. Fuck. Yeah. Keep it raw, nigga. I feel the way I'm
It is what it is. Nah, but that's that shit though. People don't be knowing the shit behind the scenes type shit. So people be coming down here. Be
yeah,
saying,
I love to see.
Right.
Nah, yo, see like, behind the scenes.
If y'all don't fuck with them, that's just. Nice. I didn't know that. That's just.
Nah, yeah,
nah.
I'm gonna problems with nigga. Like,
it's your own brother, nigga.
Nah, yeah.
I don't know the bit at all.
Nah, no, you're good. I'm just saying, it'd be happening sometimes. If people come on here, be saying names, it'd just be like,
yeah, hell yeah, man.
Everybody's in the room talk shit now. That hit kicking
like,
in.
Well, it usually just be either me or Carla. Like, it's one of us. Mac don't got problems with nobody.
Shout out to the rappers that don't wear fake. Yo, shout out to the rappers that don't wear fake jewelry and shit and all that.
Nah, that shit ain't relevant.
We signing out.
He said, that shit ain't relevant. All right, yo, until next time, we out this hoe.